Hey guys, this is David Cohen here to talk about Thief, which I played on the PS3. So the name of the game is Thief, which is the same name as the first game in the franchise. And this is a very old franchise. I've never actually played any of the Thief games except Master of Shadow. I think that was a PC version. But I played like 20 minutes of it, got kind of, I don't know, I was very young then. I was like a teenager. I got turned off by it. I was like, this is not the game for me, and I never played it since. But anyway, I love stealth games, so I game-flied Thief, and so my love of stealth games, I think, made me enjoy Thief quite a bit. But I know the general consensus is that Thief is extremely disappointing and is really mediocre, and much of that I will agree. There's a bunch of talk about combat, which I won't get into because I turned it off. Like, the way I had it a custom difficulty setting, so the way I played this game, I played a master difficulty setting, so it's on hard mode. So I don't know what that does. I think that just means that enemies you take so much damage and you just die. But it doesn't matter, because I made it so that it's game over when I'm discovered. So no combat. In my playthrough, I did not have a single moment of combat. So I don't know what combat is like in this game, and I don't care, because I played it stealthily. This game for me was total stealth, and I know a lot of the complaints about this game is that combat is wonky, combat is horrible. Doesn't bother me, because I didn't have a single moment of combat in this game. So that's that. Unless you consider like sneaking behind someone's back and just wonk. That's the extent of my combat. Also, I turned off, I don't know why I did this. But this is kind of regrettable, I guess. In my playthrough, I turned off the ability to pounce on someone from above. So I couldn't do that in my playthrough. So that was a little frustrating, because I think some parts of the game were designed around that ability. And I was just like, oh, I can't do that. I have to wait, and then I have to do this, and you know, shoot a water aerial, turn off that light. So a lot of trial and error, I think, for me. Just like, I get discovered, game over, restart, game over, restart. There was a lot of that for me. But I'm a very patient gamer, and I love stealth games. So, that to me didn't bother me so much. I think a lot of people, they lose patience with stealth games because a lot of aspect of it is trial and error. You go into an area, and just like, oh crap, you make a mistake, and boom, you're discovered, and you have to restart the experience again. I feel like, generally, you know, average person who plays video games probably hates that. They just want to be like, oh, discover, kill everyone, move through the game. You know, that's why first-person shooters are so popular. Just get to go into a room and just, like, start mowing people down and move on. Stealth games, you have to be much more methodical, much more patient, look around your surroundings. And so, I think that was really good. I really like Thief as just a pure kind of a stealth experience. When it got really weird for me was, I don't know, Thief, this new version, has no sense of identity. It doesn't know what it wants to be. That's the feeling I get. Does it want to be a stealth game? Does it want to be a first-person parkour game like Mirror's Edge? Does it want to be an open-world game with side quests? I don't know. Does it want to be, like, it's very weird to get. Does it want to be like a platforming game with cinematic experiences like Uncharted? And oh man, and the boss fights. There's two boss fights in this game at the end. Awful. And extremely hard for me because I played it so stealthily. So I guess trying to stealth my way out of both those boss fights. So I didn't fight both boss fights. But it was frustrating. Like the final boss, for example, she just explodes, you know, and you have to be like at a certain location to dodge that, and the timing of that boss fight was so much trial and error for me. Like, I think I retried that like 30 times at least or something like that. I was just getting so frustrated. Like, I have to go here, I have to go there. It was all very timed, and just the design of that is so freaky, so weird. Oh, I also did not like the eerie supernatural sequences. I don't know why first-person experience games do this all the time, and I hate it. Fear did it. Halo's done it. I think almost every first-person experience games out there have done these little sequences where it gets all eerie and supernatural. And in Thief, you pretty much just kind of guide the player around in a hallway. Or you get lost, and you just walk and run. You can't really do anything. It's just like a waste of gameplay moments. Like, I don't know why I'm doing them. If this method is being used to tell a story immersively, it is not worth. The story in Thief, probably the most to me, one of the most disappointing aspects of Thief is the storytelling. It's crap, honestly. Like, the dialogues, much of it doesn't make sense. The ending is haphazard. It's very weird. Like, you know, the motive behind Garrett, you know, doing all these things, stealing these items, it's not a very good story, but I do like the environment a little bit, you know, just sneaking past things. The hub world integration was, I don't know, I kind of mixed feelings. On the one hand, I did like the fact that I can revisit missions. That's really cool, you know, explore around, but then having to go through this drab hub world every time, and there are certain parts where it's so like frustrating to sneak past, except to kind of like use weird techniques to get past them. And there's not many like abilities that Garrett has other than like roll and the arrows that he has. Only very few arrows were useful to me because I, you know, like I said, my playthrough had no combat, you know, so water arrows, you know, I could shoot out the lights, whatever. The blunt arrows, arrows that make sound when you shoot, very few. I hardly killed anyone this game. I don't think I've killed anyone this game, actually. So, actually, I had a tough time on a lot of the parts. Some parts were extremely challenging because of the way I played it. Because, like I said, it's game over the moment I'm discovered. But it's totally possible to play it this way. And some parts were very thrilling. Some parts were just kind of like, oh man, like, you know. But overall, it was a good stealth experience. I love stealth games. But yeah, I just, you know, it is kind of disappointing that this was the end product that they ended up with. It's amazing. I know the development history. I was going back through some of my old Game Informer magazines. And Thief, oh my gosh, it's been in development for like 6 years or something like that. So this is a game that's been long in development, long in hype, long in anticipation, and this is the end product. So considering all that is hugely disappointing, and I bet it's disappointing for the developers and game publishers as well, how it turned out, you know, the critical response to it, the public response to it. I feel like Thief wanted to be so much, but it didn't really get it. I didn't really get a sense of what it was, you know. There are some areas where it really shines, like the introduction. The introduction sequence, I really, really enjoyed. But yeah, I just, I don't know. Like, those cinematic instances where you have to go through, you're being chased by fire, and you have to outrun the fire, like, frustrating. You know, there are those instances where it wants to be cinematic. I hated those moments in this game. All those platforming moments. Like, platforming is cool, you know, and all. But the way it's done, that you're like, constantly, like, pushed to go faster and faster and jump here and there and there. Yeah, it wasn't the best way it was done. But yeah, overall, like, I enjoyed my experience with Thief, but I think that's kind of more on a personal level, because I really enjoy these types of games more so than any other types of games. I love stealth games. I don't know what it is. Like, I just like the idea of, like, you know, sneaking around, being methodical, and not having to do any combat, just stealing things and raking up that gold. The amount of gold you get is very few. I didn't really get much out of the side missions. Really, you just kind of explore the hub and try to steal stuff. didn't really get too much out of that, you know? I did some, and I was like, this is kind of boring for me. I'm just going to go back to the main story missions. The main story missions are much, much more linear. But, I don't know, there are many pathways to go from here to there that they've included, which I thought was cool. I don't really have too much of an issue with the level design except the mental asylum that you end up going to. Did not like that level at all. It's just kind of, you know, there's a feeling of I've been here, I've done that. And also, like, it's not very, like, I don't know, like, not much stealth in there. And just kind of, that was a boring level, I think, overall. But, yeah, that's pretty much my thoughts on Thief. Just a pretty, like, fairly enjoyable game if you're into stealth games. But there's nothing that stands out about it, you know? There isn't, like, something that makes me go, like, you should go play Thief. It's a pretty forgettable experience after you play it, which is very disappointing because there are a lot of really cool concepts and ideas here. I don't know. I would definitely be interested in the sequel and see how that goes. There is so much room for improvement with this franchise and with this kind of game directions they've taken in particular. But as it stands, Thief for the, you know, PlayStation 3, PlayStation 4, Xbox 360, Xbox One, PC, meh. That's the general opinion. And I think that's the general consensus too. But yeah, if you guys enjoyed the video, cheers.